On a lot of the new angling line waters, one of the main rules that you have to abide by is the use of totally barbless hooks. That's not crimped hooks, it's totally barbless hooks. So this year especially I've had to adapt and change over to a barbless hook system. What I'm going to show you is the barbless hook system that I've adapted. I'll call it the ultimate barbless hook. It's taken after the ultimate pop-up rig. Very good rig. I was at a lake called Bree last week. I had 13 runs and landed 13 fish. Prior to that at home I've tried it and I've had 6 runs and landed 6 fish. So I've lost no fish on it. I say it's totally barbless as they come out of the packet. Now the hooks I'm using are SmartPoint SP315s, which is the barbless version. I shall be using Merlin, Criston Merlin in 15 lb, and shrink tube, which you get from thefishingbag.com. So first of all, what I'll do, I'll just take some Merlin and just put a small knot in for the hair. And then going to take around about 12 to 15 inches of the braid. I'll have one of the SP315s. So now all we do is just put in a knotless knot. So I'll thread the braid down through the eye of the hook. I'm going to leave around about half an inch to 3/4 inch of air, and then about 10 turns pass that back through the eye of the hook. A little bit of saliva. And then I'll just tie in a figure of 8 knot at the other end. Saliva, there you go. There's your figure of 8 knot. I'll just tighten them up. Pull them nice and tight. Trim off the braid where the figure of 8 knot was. Now what I'm going to do is take just a small section. We're going to take round about 3/4 inch of shrink tube. And then thread that onto the braid. Now with this, what I do with this is push this shrink tube down so it's right opposite the point, like so. So you've got the air sticking out. Now normally with the ultimate pop-up rig, what I did is put some 30 lb Seaguar fluorocarbon through the middle. I found that the fishingbag.com shrink tube is firm enough once it's steamed to remain in place. So I'm not going to bother with the fluorocarbon. I'm just going to steam that right away and I'll show you how I do that. So what I do is drop it into the boiling water, leave it for a few seconds, take it out, and then just bend the tubing like so, just keep it in place until it forms a nice link like that. So that's so there you have the finished product. You can either use it as a pop-up, as with the ultimate pop-up rig, but the beauty with this is, although it's barbless, this bit of tubing ensures that if that goes into the fish's mouth, it remains there, so it doesn't fall out. But as soon as it goes into the net, it's so easy to take out, it's just a matter of just removing it and it's free from the fish. That's the ultimate barbless rig with the boilie, and again, as you can see, it always catches the fish. It's a very good rig for a barbless hook, and to date I think it's something like 19 fish I've had, and I haven't lost a single one. Everyone's been landed on this. It's how it comes out of the packet, and with all the Bachelier waters, which is the likes of Jean Cherie, Brie, Brocard, and also the likes of Old Oaks, Larousse, the rules are very strict, and barbless hooks are the rule. This can be used as a pop-up rig as well as a bottom bait. So we just put a pop-up on. Obviously the only difference with the pop-up, we need some shot. A couple of shots should do it. And that will sit off the bottom of the lake, just like that. We're using the barbless hooks on here, obviously. And we'll just show these as how they come out. There you go, that's it. Not difficult at all. It leaves no mouth damage. There you go, no mouth damage at all. Perfect.